Regions across our area are creating potential breeding grounds for mosquitoes and West Nile virus. Today, health officials with the Centers for Disease Control said cases of the virus rose 40% nationwide in just 1 week. West Nile is now in 48 states, has sickened 1,600 people and killed 66. New at 11 tonight, News 4's Kim Quintero joins us with how you can keep mosquitoes from turning your home into theirs. Kim?
Well, Carol, it starts with getting rid of standing water. If you take a look around outside your home, you'll probably see a number of simple items, like an old pet bowl, creating a sanctuary for mosquitoes.
Take a look at this. Small mosquito larvae wiggled in a puddle of water less than 48 hours after rain collected on the edge of a trampoline outside this Greenville County home.
Within a few more days, these will go into adults, and you'll have children on the trampoline, and this water is here, they'll get bit by the mosquitoes.
A major concern, as health officials call 2012 a record-setting year for the number of reported cases of West Nile. In South Carolina, the Department of Health and Human Services reports mosquitoes carrying the virus have sickened 15 people, including three in the upstate.
This puddle has been here since Tuesday when the rain started.
Ross Whittle with Hired Killers Pest Control says recent rains will only add fuel to the fire, as stagnant water fills crevices around homes and businesses, creating habitats for the insects.
Swing sets that are hollow can get water inside of them. You know, the places that you don't think about a lot, that's really where you need to be concerned with.
Something as small as a bottle cap left behind that filled up with rainwater could also be breeding grounds for mosquitoes.
You just have to be really careful. You know, don't take anything for granted.
Dishes under potted plants, car wash buckets, and drainage basins are also prime spots.
This kind of area can produce thousands of mosquitoes, and this area is within 100 feet of the house.
The water here can be easily swept out, but larger areas may need to be treated by a professional. An effort to keep mosquitoes away and prevent bites from becoming much more than an itch.
Early fall is usually when mosquitoes have the highest levels of the virus and when human cases tend to peak. The CDC recommends protecting yourself outside with an insect repellent containing DEET. Carol?
Kim, thanks. Health officials say about 80% of people infected with West Nile show no symptoms at all. The other 20% can have fever, headache, body aches, nausea, vomiting, and sometimes swollen lymph glands. Some develop a rash. Symptoms may last anywhere from a few days to several weeks.